Mexican spirituality is a complicated tapestry woven from the diverse threads of Roman Catholicism and native Indian customs. The festival of the Day of the Dead is a celebration where people leave food and gifts for the souls of the dead, whom they believe return to Earth for only one day each year. It grew out of the Catholic holiday of All Souls Day. Every Christian religious festival in Mexico is overlaid with a mystical veneer and underpinned by centuries of folk tradition. Every year, that rich folk culture travels to the north when hundreds of thousands of migrant laborers work their way through the laden groves and ripe fields of California, especially the lush San Joaquin Valley, about 2 hours' drive northeast of Los Angeles. The valley produces more fruit and employs more migrant workers than any other stretch of land its size in the United States. Many of the migrant workers are now permanent residents of the San Joaquin Valley, and their folkways have become an ingrained part of the valley's rare hybrid lifestyle, part modern American farmland, part isolated Mexican village. One Mexican tradition that has flourished in Central California is a curandero, or folk healer. Don Luis Saldana is a respected curandero who lives in the San Joaquin Valley. He uses herbs, potions, and folk rituals that have been handed down over generations, and he accepts only voluntary contributions from his patients. Don Luis believes that charging a fee is directly contrary to the type of spiritual work he performs. His patient today feels that she has been cursed. Don Luis will try to cleanse her by using an egg. He moves the egg close to her body, chanting and praying to Jesus to intercede on her behalf.
A curandero or a curandera occupies an important role in traditional Mexican culture. People look up to them. They trust them. And so then they would go to a curandero, whom they feel they can trust, with whom they feel much more at ease, whom they feel understands their culture and their feelings and their suffering a lot better.
Don Luis examines the air bubbles that form when he breaks the egg into water. He thinks the bubbles will give him insight into his patient's problems. Alma Chavez, the woman Don Luis Saldana was trying to heal, told us that she felt much better after 3 treatments. Clearly, the combination of religion and folk culture practiced by curanderos can be highly effective for the people who believe in it. Sadly, their faith sometimes puts them at the mercy of phony curanderos who take advantage of their trust in order to swindle them. In February of 1988, a woman we'll call Maria Martinez left home headed for work as a laborer in the San Joaquin Valley's orange groves. She saw a strange cross on her sidewalk and immediately knew she had been cursed.
It was a big cross with dirt. It had red chilies. It had 3 pennies, and it was made out of cemetery dirt. I was crying, and I got upset, and that's when I started getting confused about all those things, you know. So I went to talk to this lady, and she told me, she says, you know, somebody's doing some bad witchcraft on you.
To our victim, it seems that these superstitions are real. They're not just something that's elusive or vague. They're real things, and so there's a real fear involved, as much as if there was someone threatening her face to face.
Señor Cortez? Sí, estoy llamando de Fresno. Y tengo tanto miedo porque estaba saliendo de la...
Maria believed that a female rival for her boyfriend's affections had put a hex on her. Frightened, she contacted a curandero whose business card she had gotten at a local fair. Maria made an appointment to see the curandero the next day at his office in the nearby town of Visalia. The curandero, Jorge Cortez, told Maria that he could cure her problem for $100. He then told her to rub a cigarette between her palms and say 3 Hail Marys.
En el nombre del Señor, Padre del Hijo y el Espíritu Santo, pidemos, Dios mío, que nos hagas este milagro. Mira.
When he slapped her hands, the cigarette appeared to turn into a rolled up $100 bill.
¿Sabes qué? Es tuyo. porque ya va a cambiar tu suerte. Te digo que yo tengo la fuerza de los siete poderes.
When I opened my hand, this $100 bill was in my hand out of the tobacco I had in my hand. And I was scared. I was really scared after I saw that.
Jorge asked Maria to take off her clothes so he could purify her.
Cierra los ojos, hermana.
He performed a series of procedures on Maria, including rubbing an egg over her body. He appealed to the Virgin Mary and to Jesus to neutralize the hex. Maria was embarrassed, but she was so frightened of the curse that she allowed him to proceed.
The curandero is protecting himself from arrest by literally intimidating the victims. The victims come in there trusting him, and his victims are primarily middle-aged Hispanic women, and in having them disrobe and rubbing them with a candle and an egg, that's something that's difficult to explain to their husbands. Why would they take their clothes off in front of a man they don't know? And so a lot of these victims, they don't want that made public. They don't want to come to the police department because of their fear of problems in the family, and also because of the real fear that this man has supernatural powers.
Abre los ojos y mira. Te voy a demostrar.
At the end of the session, Jorge cracked open the egg. It was black, indicating that a portion of the evil spell had been removed. But Jorge said the purification was not complete.
Pero no temes, porque yo puedo cambiar todo eso para ti. Te vas a poner mejor. Ya no vas a tener problemas. Yo te voy a ayudar.
Jorge told Maria that she would have to come back and that she would need more money.
Amen.
2 weeks later, Maria went to the Fresno bus station to pick up a man and a woman Jorge had asked her to meet. The woman carried a briefcase.
Hola, muy bien, ¿ustedes?
They went to a local motel where Jorge was waiting for them. He said he had a powerful demonstration he wanted them to witness.
Hermano, espéranos aquí un momento, por favor.
He asked Maria and the other woman to go into an adjacent room. Jorge followed the women and told the young man to wait for them. Inside the next room, Jorge opened the woman's briefcase, revealing to Maria that $7,000 was inside.
Que yo, con la ayuda del Señor, voy a convertir este dinero, esta cantidad de dinero, en medio millón de dólares para la hermana. Sí. Les voy a pedir que por favor me ayuden. Primeramente, darme estas velas. Permítame pagar las luces. Ahora, les voy a pedir de que se agarren de la mano, por favor. Y vamos a hacer una oración en el nombre de Dios. Párenme la mano y cierren los ojos, por favor. Padre nuestro que estás
en los cielos, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nuestro reino. Hágase, Señor, tu voluntad, así en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos el pan de cada día y perdona nuestra deuda, así como nosotros perdonamos a quien nos ofende. Que no nos dejes caer en tentación, líbranos de todo mal. Amén.
Ah, mira, hermana, milagro que nos hizo Dios.
Ay, mira, dinero, mira, ya estoy rica. Ay, dame un abrazo. No voy a ser pobre nunca, no.
My theory is that this elderly woman and the young man were in on this scam with Jorge, and their part in this game is to make something that's too good to be true look like it really happened.
The scam worked. Maria was completely sold on Jorge's magical ability to create money. 1 month later, on March the 25th, Maria and Jorge went to her bank. She had with her a check for $7,844.95, money she had acquired by taking out a loan on her house. The bank's camera recorded Maria and Jorge as they cashed her check at the teller's window. These are the only known photographs of Jorge Cortez.
Es muy importante que pónganos.
Back at Maria's house, Jorge performed his final trick. He put all her money in a suitcase and mixed pieces of newspaper among the bills. Jorge then lit 17 candles arranged on a tray in the form of a cross. He carefully placed the tray next to Maria's bed and asked her to leave the room so he could perform some private ministrations to make the magic work.
¿Me permite un momento, hermano? Tengo que hacer unas oraciones en privado.
Sí, claro.
Por favor, sálvese del cuarto.
Gracias. Jorge warned Maria that if she did not follow his directions to the letter, her money would not be increased.
Hermano, ya terminé. Todo va a estar muy bien. En unas cuantas horas, usted va a ser muy rica. Me perdona, pero me tengo que ir.
When Jorge emerged from the bedroom, he told Maria he had to leave. He promised to call her the next morning and warned her not to open the suitcase until noon. One of Maria's neighbors dropped Jorge off at his destination. He was last seen at the corner of Fulton and Fresno Streets, a busy intersection in downtown Fresno. The next day, exactly at noon, Maria opened her suitcase. She found nothing but newspapers. Maria was devastated.
People that does things like this, it's bad. Because I don't think they have any feelings. They don't have anything. They just want the money. They just want to take whatever they can from other people. And they don't care how they get it.
The man known as Jorge Cortez is currently wanted by the Fresno police on charges of grand theft. Once his true identity is known, a warrant will be issued. He may be using the alias of Jorge Lopez or George Lopez. He's of Mexican descent, about 45 years old and 5 feet 6 inches tall. He weighs about 150 pounds and has black hair and brown eyes. According to the Fresno police, hundreds of women have fallen victim to Jorge Cortez. It is likely that the number of victims is continuing to rise, that he's practicing his sham healing somewhere in Central California. Police urge other victims of Jorge Cortez to come forward despite their fear and embarrassment. If you have any information about him, please call Detective Frank Clark of the Fresno, California Police Department, or call our toll-free number, 1-800-876-5353.